the last
one. Well, that was my second guess, and I would have felt a lot better.
I should just look at the Avengers.
Number three, Identity Thief.
Identity, another one's from McCarthy. Look at Jason Bateman.
Number two, 21 Jump Street.
Jonah Hill, yeah, Channing Tatum.
And number Ice one, Cube. Number one, Tyler got this, The Hunger Games. There you go.
You know what I think I found the theme? It's someone in one of these movies, the lead actors, the ladies like them. You know what I mean? Like Jennifer Lawrence. Your lady probably likes Jennifer Lawrence. 21 Jump Street. Channing Tatum.
Yeah.
Identity Theft. You saw how many Melissa McCarthy movies around here.
A couple of everywhere.
Apparently she's popular with the women.
No, you know, Bridesmaids wasn't on that list.
Surprisingly, yes, you're right. Surprisingly not on the list.
There you go.
Which one of those are you going to rent now?
To be honest with you, if I were going to watch one of these and I have seen none of them...
That's amazing, by the way, that you've seen none of them.
I wonder how long this list would go before we get to that. Like if it went 16, 17, 18, 19...
29 deep.
I think I've seen every one of these, Gator.
I've seen all but, I think, one. And I haven't seen Divergent yet, and that might be the only one I haven't seen.
21 Jump Street?
21 Jump Street is funny.
It is pretty funny.
21 Jump Street 2 is funny too. Or
22 Jump Street.
That's funny. Channing Tatum's funny.
Well, because he plays the perfect role. That dumb idiot.
John. Kind of weirdo guy, but he's funny.
Where the Millers was on the other night, but I...
You didn't watch it, huh?
No. And you know what else was on? I watched for about 15 minutes last night, and I had to make that decision. I'm either going to keep going with this, or I'm going to pull a plug. And I pulled the plug. Concussion.
Tell the truth.
Yeah. Wasn't my thing.
Sacco Malu? Will Smith?
Yeah.
Albert Brooks?
Alright, so... Anyway, Jeff Lessons update's coming up here.
David Morris, who plays Mike Webster. Yeah.
What do you think... Well, he was a mess. What do you think is how Lessons going to rip on Tiger Woods in this update? Who leads the Hero World Challenge at 600 right now?
He's going to bring up the drunk draft.
Okay, Kang, what do you think he's going to do?
This might be the cop-out easy one, but he's going to bring up his world ranking.
That's what I was going to say. Despite not being ranked in the top 1,150 of golfers in the world, Tiger Woods leads the Hero World Challenge. All right, find out next. Lessons update coming up. 97.1 The Ticket.
Jamie and Stoney. Morning.
Coming up Monday morning in the 6 o'clock hour.
Do the Lions still have a playoff pulse?
And at 8 o'clock, your chance to win Red Wings Jets tickets. Jamie and Stoney. Mornings. 6 to 10.
Here to help make your celebration delicious with low prices on traditional flavors and new favorites they'll savor. So every moment is truly special. Happy holidays from Kroger.
USDA Choice Boneless Shoulder Roasts are buy one, get one free. And Red Sizzler Sprays are $1.28 a pound with plus cards. Fresh food, low prices at Kroger.
It's back for the holidays. Now at Kroger, you can earn 4 times the fuel points on gift cards. Just download your digital coupon at Kroger.com, then head to Kroger and choose from brands like Cheesecake Factory, Google Play, Fandango, Panera, and more. Get ready for your holiday shopping and earn 4 times the fuel points. Buy here, use there. Save at the pump with your digital coupon from Kroger.com. Limited time offer, restrictions apply. See store for details. Fresh food, low prices at Kroger.
SunTrust Mortgage Incorporated, NMLS number 2915, is an equal housing lender. For full licensing information, visit suntrust.com/mortgage.
When you help that first-time homeowner get a mortgage, it's the best. Owning a home is the American dream, right?
Faith Martin for SunTrust Mortgage.
I encourage people to shop around because I know that when all is said and done, you're going to like what you see at SunTrust Mortgage. It's so much more than just finding you the best rate. A mortgage is one of the biggest decisions you make in life, so it's important to be with a lender you trust. When you work with us, we'll make sure that you're being taken care of. We believe that everyone can achieve financial confidence, and we want to help you discover the sense of freedom that comes with a strong foundation, like the right mortgage. I love what I do. How great is that?
SunTrust. Confidence starts here. To discuss your options and take advantage of today's historically low interest rates, call us now at 1-800-333-9615. That's 1-800-333-9615. 1-800-333-9615. 615.
Wow. No wonder everyone waits for Macy's friends and family.
Well, it's their best sale of the season.
Yep. We'll get an extra 10 to 30% savings with our Macy's Carter Savings Pass.
Even on designers that rarely go on sale.
Oh, you'll love this. 15% off beauty purchases.
That doesn't happen very often.
Plus, great savings on perfect gifts.
Like I always say, friends and family are really all that matters.
So the extra 30% savings?
Yeah, that matters too. Macy's friends and family sales. Savings off regular and sale prices. Exclusions apply.
Save more with Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Ollie, it's such a cute snowflake. Where's the costume from? Thanks. Liberty Mutual saved us some money, so it's custom made. Liberty did what? Oh, switch to our auto and home insurance and save almost $800. I wish we saved like that. Sarah's costume could use some work. Like, she's a cute horse. Sharon, she's a turkey.
Visit us online to get a quote. You can save $782 when Liberty stands with you. Liberty Mutual Insurance. Based on recent countrywide new customer survey, coverage is underwritten by Liberty Mutual Insurance Company, Equal Housing Insurer.
Divorce can be a traumatic experience. I'm pro football legend Barry Sanders, and when I was facing my divorce, I didn't know of Cordell and Cordell, but now I do. The family law attorneys of Cordell and Cordell have made it their mission to preserve the roles of dads in their children's lives. I met with Cordell and Cordell attorneys. I sat down with their clients and heard their stories. I know that Cordell and Cordell's priority is to protect and promote men's financial and family interests in all stages of divorce. Don't face this process alone. Consider Cordell and Cordell, a partner men can count on.
Contact the domestic litigation firm of Cordell and Cordell to schedule an appointment with one of our firm's Michigan attorneys. 313-465-1999. That's 313-465-1999. Online at CordellCordell.com. That's CordellCordell.com. CordellCordell.com. Offices in Troy, Ann Arbor, and Southfield. This is a paid endorsement. Endorser is not a client.
Foundation Systems of Michigan, the largest foundation contractor in the state, is having a career fair. Join them Wednesday, December 6th at 6 p.m. at their Livonia office. If you have experience in construction, sales, customer service, or accounting, come stop by. Visit drymish.com. Equal opportunity employer.
This hour of instant feedback brought to you by Mike Papura of National Benefit Plans. For affordable health insurance, log on to nbphealth.com.
WXYT FM and WXYT HD1 Detroit. Sports headlines all day, every day. This is 97.1 The Ticket.
Pistons on a four-game road trip tonight. It starts in D.C. with the Wizards. Looking to make it four wins in a row. They are in 5-6. Washington playing with an all-star point guard, John Wall, the left knee. Hear it right here at 7 on 97.1 The Ticket. Lions getting ready for Baltimore in Baltimore on Sunday. A little banged up there on the offensive line. Both Travis Swanson and T.J. Lang missing practice yesterday. Matt Stafford, though, was a full participant, so it looks like that ankle sprain may not be much of an issue. College hoops this weekend as Big Ten Conference play opens up. The Wolverines are the good one. They've got Indiana tomorrow afternoon at 12:30 at the Chrysler Center. You can hear that over on AM 950 WWJ. At the Hero World Challenge, 18-man field, not 150, like a tour event on a pitch and putt resort course with wide open fairways and flat greens. The easiest course these guys will play all year, and it's an exhibition. Tiger Woods driving and putting well, one shot off the lead at 6-under par through six holes. He's 3-under in the day. So I guess that means he'll win the Masters. He is still as chunking his chips and blading bunker shots. Last year at the same event, he said he felt great. Actually led the field in birdies, then went out at a real tour event and crapped the bed a couple times and had back surgery. At the Ticket Update Desk, I'm Jeff Lesson. For more, 97.1 theticket.com.
Double down.
Okay.
Eight of the top 10 golfers in the world are playing this, though, right?
We have no winner in the Predict How Jeff Lesson will rip on Tiger Woods in the update contest. Kang and I thought you'd make fun of his world ranking. Gator thought you'd bring up the DUI.
No.
But you just slammed the living crap out of his entire game.
Everything, yeah.
Let me ask you this. How much stock do you put in exhibition football, baseball, I don't know, basketball, or not?
Not much.
Well, I suggest you put the same amount of importance.
Well, hold on,
you can't compare that. These guys are playing the whole course. They're not playing like the first three holes and turning it over to their caddy.
They don't play the same course
they
usually won the regular tour.
You got to learn how to speak into a microphone.
Yeah, you got to turn that one for. Yeah, there you go.
Learning. It's not a tour event. There's no cut. There's 18 holes. There's 100. It's sure it does.
No, it doesn't.
You think this means a lot to all those other guys? They're all rooting for Tiger because they know he's the reason they made all their paychecks. And that's true.
So when it gets to an event, and they're not going to get here?
All right, what did he tell us last year? He told us he felt great, never felt better, went out, led the field in birdies last year. Everyone said, including you, right, oh, my God, this looks so good for him. How'd that work out? Well, then he got to a real course and a real event, and he came back to reality. And so you're telling me this year, all of a sudden you believe the guy? He's telling you the truth that he feels great?
No, I think it looks great. But you poo-pooing the course, I think, is ridiculous given the field that's out there. These guys do care to play the best golf every time they're out there. They're on television. They don't want to embarrass themselves.
They're not embarrassed.
They're some of the best golfers in the world. They're in the top 10.
Agreed.
This is a course that you may call pitch and putt resort course. And, okay, it's not the most difficult with the greens given because it's flatter.
And it's wider.
Yeah, but it doesn't take away the fact that still the better golfers in the world are playing in this.
Right.
And no one has an advantage because half these guys belong to the course in the first place.
Well, let me ask you this. How much do you think this event means to Dustin Johnson? And versus how much do you think it means to Tiger Woods?
Well, I don't know if it means a whole lot to either one of them in the grand scheme.
You don't think it means a lot to Tiger Woods?
I think it means a lot.
I think it means a lot to Tiger Woods. He's playing well.
Yeah, and he played well last year, too. Led the field in birdies. How'd that work out? You know what? Do me a favor. Wake me up when he makes a cut.
All right, we will.
That was a cannonading blast. That was the most over-the-top, absolute rip job from Lesson on Tiger Woods ever.
That was, you brought it up, huh?
He might want to lay low for a while. Wow. Red Wings last night. Now, Gator, I don't know how much flipping around you were doing. I know you were totally dialed in with the Spartans. After about 5 minutes of Michigan State and Notre Dame, I thought I'd pretty much seen all I needed to see, as Michigan State was so much better than the Fighting Irish. And they came back and made a rally in the second half, but whatever. I was flipping around, had the Red Wing game on, and was thinking about a call we got about how they had slow starts, and the Red Wings actually took a 2-1 lead in this game against Montreal, and then it all unraveled, and they lost 6-3.
That's right.
And after the game, Jeff Blashill, head coach, we've discussed quite a bit, sort of the season and his approach and where he is and where Holland is, the purge last year, draft picks, and the youth movement, and the new building, and all these things. But Blashill sometimes gets upset with the way they play, and he doesn't mind singling guys out and singling out bad play, and he did last night. First, he described what kind of hockey the Red Wings play.
Stupid hockey. Just craziness, to be honest with you. You know, you come out, you have a real good first period overall. You just can't give away easy goals in this league. You know, somebody said back there, it didn't look like we had any energy in the second or third. We don't have energy because you suck the energy out of yourself by giving away easy goals.
Yeah, I heard that last night after the game. What he said, he sucked, and then there's a little pause, almost like the team sucked. Sucked the energy right out of it. Look, they looked awful in the second period. I can't disagree with him in that giving up bad goals will suck the life out of a team. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to disagree with that.
Stupid hockey. I think when you start getting into those terms, you catch your team's attention, but you have to be careful. Because they can check out on you, can't they?
Sure.
If you get too carried away. He questioned their commitment to win.
Not enough guys with the real crazy commitment to win. And by that I mean find their way to not quite in the shot lane. Found a way to not quite win a battle. Just enough guys not doing those things, the little things it takes to win.
Find a way to not quite be in the shot line. Find a way to not quite win a battle. I feel as though... Let me... Scotty Bowman. Would you ever expect Scotty Bowman, when he sat down with his team, to, like, go over some stuff, look at film? Do you think he would ever sugarcoat anything?
No.
I don't either. And I don't think Mike Babcock would, and I don't think Jeff Blashill would. I think we got an indication there, right there, something he might point out to his team and say, you, look at this, you, had a chance to get in the shot lane, and you don't. You don't want to get hit by the puck here. Like, I think he singles guys out. You went in the corner, and you didn't. You got outworked.